Humans have long hunted belugas for food. In the high Arctic, Inuits still do. But when Europeans came, belugas were used to feed machines as well as people. We killed them for leather. We killed them for oil. In the 1860s, a few of them became the first whales ever captured alive for show business. In the 1920s, they were accused of competing with the fishing industry, and people were paid to kill them. That ended after a scientist looked in the stomachs of dead ones and saw mostly small fish, not cod. But at the same time, our booming industrial civilization was literally getting under their skin. With steel, coal, and automobiles, the vast St. Lawrence watershed became for a while the main engine of global industrial growth. Right here, humans learned that we can make things that are bigger than we ever could have imagined, including mistakes.
Because they live only a few hundred kilometers downstream from the Great Lake, from the heart of America, and all the mistakes we made over the last decades somehow ended up in the beluga tissues. Each beluga is somehow telling us that recent history of North America.
Harpoons, guns, poisonous contaminants, and other killers took their toll. And by the 1960s, one thing was clear. The St. Lawrence belugas were almost gone.